Greetings from Trent University's Justin Chiu Stadium. We're just about set for the start of the bronze medal game in these 2010 CIS Women's Rugby Championships. I'm Sandy Kay. With me is Ed Holton. Pleased to bring you the coverage of these final two games of the tournament, and these, Ed, will deliver the medals.
Exactly, Sandy. Very exciting game coming up here. Lethbridge and Guelph. Some people were expecting to see these two in the championship, but they've ended up in the bronze game. They're certainly playing for a medal. They want the bronze medal.
And kick is underway, and we are playing rugby.
Keep walking it back.
You hear the voice there of referee Andrew Hosey. He will be wired for us. We can hear play on the field. Brittany Benn for Guelph delivers the ball nicely to her backs. A little misplay there. Number 11, Morella Reneva from Guelph. Both teams suffering very, very close, heartbreaking losses yesterday. Guelph's coming at the hands of St. FX.
What a game that was, Sandy.
As exciting a game as I think I have ever seen in many years of rugby. 18-17 scored against them on the last play of the game. Lethbridge at the hands of Concordia. Ball that's number 15. Brittany Orr.
Mishandled there, too.
First one by Red. Scrum it.
Sorry, the 18-17 was Guelph's loss to St. FX. And Concordia took Lethbridge yesterday, 19-12.
Two very close games, very exciting games. Always tough getting up for a bronze medal game. You suffer those heartbreaking losses. You want to finish your season with a win.
Touch. Pause.
Which team can get up? Which team can get up for this last game of the season? Nice pass by Alex Hendricks.
And that's a tackle release.
Good trailing ball. It's number four, Stacey Hake. She's a candidate under 20.
Lethbridge got it right to the 22 now.
Ball from Alex Hendricks. There's fullback Brittany Orr again. Pick ball, forward ball. Good defense from Guelph, holding back that push. And ball out from Hendricks. Into the centers, nice switch ball, number 13.
Good hands.
Run!
That's Shannon Court for Lethbridge. And coming again.
Oh, could be a break here.
Laura Murphy-Burke did a good job there. She had a phenomenal game against Concordia yesterday. Kelsey Willoughby, All-Canadian.
There, six.
Lethbridge nicely in control of the ball here.
Nice phases of ball from the Pronghorns. Three-time national champions. They want to stay in the medals.
Oh, they've lost the ball here.
Ruck! Go ahead!
That's number one. Lisa Shellington does a good job just to preserve her own ball in her own 22.
Turned over again.
Nikki Van Eck in possession for Lethbridge. Skip ball out to number 14, Kendra Gavelin. About 5 meters out now for the Pronghorns. Getting organized in the forwards. Good drive by Lethbridge.
Ruck.
Ball spun by Hendricks. Oh, good crash by... Just looking for the name of the hooker. That's Brandy Van Ewen.
Oh, here's a little break here.
Number 5, Lindsay Duxbury.
Getting close.
She had player of the game honors earlier in this tournament. Guelph doing a good job covering defense.
Nice up in defense.
Pronghorn forwards get organized again.
Numerous phases here for Lethbridge.
First score going to be important in this one. Lethbridge looking for it. Very nice ball early from scrum half Alex Hendricks.
Quick hands.
Good steal by Guelph. Ooh, high tackle made there by the winger.
It's taken in by Red.
Brittany Benn with a good hard charging run.
Nice tackle by Duxbury. Had a penalty.
Not releasing the tackler.
Well, good defense early by Guelph, Sandy.
That's good, yeah.
Excellent job. They've preserved the 0-0 scoreboard here. We've played about 30, pardon me, we've played 5 minutes, 35 remaining.
That's right. We're playing 40-minute halves in these finals today. 35 minutes during the tournament and 40s in the finals, in the medal games.
Lots of rugby to be played today. Great crowd below us.
Mole!
Taking in these gold and bronze medal games.
Advantage offside, blue nine.
Of course, we expected great defense by Guelph. Very few points scored against them all season.
Advantage is over.
It's a good run here.
Good run by Brittany Bench. She's an All-Canadian.
14 blue roll.
Set up a nice ruck. Here come the trailing forwards.
Scrum half Marielle Lahou directs traffic. Oh, good push by Van Ewen. And we've got Lenani Funa.
There. Back it up there, 12.
Good crash ball off the side.
Ruck!
Guelph stringing together good phases of ball.
Back!
Oh. Oh, referee Andrew Hosey saying Britt Ben's ball was delivered backwards. Guelph Gryphon still in possession.
No hand seven.
Ball to Brittany Benn.
Oh, a little break here, Sandy. Look at this.
Katie McNally for Guelph breaks through.
But they've turned the ball over, I believe.
It's taken in. An advantage.
Oh, and a knock on by Lethbridge behind their own 22.
Knock on by Blue.
Brittany Orr. They didn't make sure she had the control of that ball. She was looking to kick it.
We're 6.5 minutes in. No score in this bronze medal game between Lethbridge and Blue, Guelph and the red and white. We've got two champions here. We've got the Ontario champion Gryphons and Lethbridge. From out west, as Sandy mentioned, the three-time defending CIS champions now going for bronze this year after three golds.
Saw that scrum collapse. Referee Hosey making sure that doesn't happen again. A bit of a dangerous piece of play.
Touch, pause, engage. Hold blue. An advantage.
Good aggressive move by back row players for Lethbridge, but knocked forward. Guelph will stay in possession.
Newmark is on me. Blue it is outside.
They've moved that ball outside the 22 now.
Let's slow down your front rows and engage. Both hookers. Very impressive defensive play there by Lefty. Crouch! Touch! Pause! Engage! Straight out.
Ball comes straight out. We're going to do this one again. Both teams just seeming to feel each other out here early on. We've seen the ball played between the 22s for the most part.
Crouch.
Guelph with a chance now. Bring the ball inside the Pronghorn 22. We've seen Guelph's defense active. Now we'll see about our Canada West champions. I'll take from CIS All-Canadian JC Murphy. Good pop. That was Stephanie DeVries taking it on for Guelph, but being pushed out of bounds. We're about 8 meters out.
Ball.
Good ball. That's Dewey Thompson taking it for the Pronghorns. And Lethbridge will not find touch. Oh, unfortunate there. That's a mistake for Guelph.
Not only mishandle it, but put it into touch, so it'll be Lethbridge's line out here. Well, like you said, Sandy's been pretty even. A couple chances for breaks on both sides, but nothing yet. Scoreless after 9.5 minutes.
Short lineout now coming through Lethbridge hands. And well taken by Guelph forwards.
Beaten. Burst through there.
Still advantage.
To Brittany Benn. out to Kelsey Willoughby.
Unrelease!
Back to the Pronghorns. They kick through. That pass is knocked backwards. We're fine there in the hands of fullback Katie McNally.
She had a little trouble with it, but she's got it under control now. And here they come blindside.
Good charging run. Here comes J.C. Murphy. Most outstanding player of this year's CIS.
It usually takes more than one person to bring her down.
And number seven, Patricia Harris.
Harris
another,
coming hard.
Another quick phase coming. Brittany Benn delivers it well to her centers.
Got some
They've
players
got
here.
Room on the outside.
Oh, close.
That was Dominique Monahan with an outstanding run. OUA Rookie of the Year for Guelph.
Outside. Yeah.
Guelph really did a good job moving that ball.
See the overlap coming. They got it out to her. But she was taken out of bounds about 10 meters out.
Brittany Orr, great job on defense. All-Canadian in her own right in Canada under 20.
There's the mall.
Nice line out by Lethbridge.
Back it up, Red.
And a good drive to follow it up.
That's the mall on Red.
Mall's on Red, referee tells us.
Both spins off the mall.
Good spin. That was Stacey Hake, another Canada under 20.
And got it outside the 22.
Line.
Lethbridge not panicking behind their own 22, making the saving tackle, and then rolling mall to get outside the 22. Good work.
They had very close games yesterday.
Their first games.
First games of the season for both, and I expect that neither wants to have that second on their record.
No.
We're going to get another close one.
No, you would never expect either of these teams to come and lose two games of these championships.
Number 17, Miranda Smith for Guelph.
Guelph moving the ball nicely.
She stays in the field of play.
It's gone into touch. And good support.
Touch judge Jerry Clayton signals that ball has found its way to the outside.
And who's reffing today, Sandy?
That is Andrew Hosey.
Is he a married man? Just wondered if there's a ring around the Hosey.
Well done.
Thanks. Had to get your titly tee back, Sandy.
No hands!
Guelph is looking good here.
No, blue are going forward. We'll scrum it down, blue ball.
Scrum to Lethbridge.
They're inside their own 22, so one would think they'd look to find touch here to clear their end.
Keep that 5-10.
Earlier you saw hometown host Trent unfortunately go down to defeat to Queens, so Queens takes the fifth place game. And this is four bronze.
Six, you're out.
Kick up, but she didn't find touch.
Levin Morella Reneva does a good job taking that bounce off the carpet.
Back it up there.
Lehu for Guelph. Good hands by Brittany Benn. Good shoestring catch. She breaks some tackles.
Almost
does
through.
A good, great job to get back to her feet.
Roll.
Lehu again.
Some people out wide.
That's DeVries.
Eight roll.
Number one, Lisa Shellington crashing. Good phase of the ball from University of Guelph. Seven, Patricia Harris.
Hold.
Good big run by J.C. Murphy. Offload number five, Caitlin Beaton.
Good support. Here they go again. They're quick off the next phase. Look up the center.
Brittany Bent. Oh. Looked like that one could have gone sideways, but.
Blue 13.
Offside against Lethbridge.
See if they're looking to go for posts, and they are.
Mm-hmm. And a tight game. They want to get the first points, Sandy.
And points may be hard to come by today. Two evenly matched, powerful teams.
We're playing 40-minute halves, and we are about 14 minutes in. And Guelph is going to go for three.
Looks like number 13, Shannon Spurrell, going to be doing the kicking. Brittany Benn's been their kicker for a lot of the season. That I'm a little curious to see why she's not doing the honors.
I was thinking that.
Been one of the OUA scoring leaders.
Almost directly in front of the posts.
Very makeable kick for Guelph. Here's Spurrell. It's low.
No, she missed that. Wow.
Score still scoreless. Under 25 minutes now to play.
Oh, restart with a 22 by Lethbridge, and they're not wasting any time.
Delivered well. Oh, unlucky bounce. So Guelph stays at the 22 with another opportunity to put it.
Friends and Goblin were out there to receive that 22, but it took a funny bounce, as you mentioned.
Oh, missed opportunity there for Guelph to put some early points on the board.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, good steal by Ogrens.
Knocked on by Guelph in the lineout. We'll bring it in 15 for the Lethbridge scrum.
Ogren's coming down with a bit of a limp.
Get the line out sorted earlier, okay?
Yes, sir.
You're delaying. Let's not go beyond that. Outside.
Great rugby so far, Sandy.
Very impressive work by both teams.
Crouch.
Good aggressive play in the forwards on both sides
Pause.
Of the ball.
Engage.
And some nice ball movement in the backfield. That's Alex Hendricks delivering.
Oh.
Good kick by Murphy Burke. Looks like the Guelph defender there just held up a little bit. We'd like to see them come through there, even having a dive at that ball. Brianna Newman now for Guelph.
Nice line.
Oh, we got Lethbridge hands on that
ball. Onside, blue one, onside.
Good rip. That's number five, Caitlin Beaton for Guelph. Winger Reneva in to help out. Love to see the wingers rocking hard.
Well, who took that?
And the advantage red, one.
Oh, and here comes an advantage to Guelph.
If we've got any young players watching this game at home, all 15 players need to rock the ball. You saw Reneva doing it there. Ball out to Ben.
Oh, and look at the overlap out here.
Nice little play. Room to run.
3-on-1. And this will be touchdown in the corner.
Dominic Monahan looking for it.
Oh, that had try written all over it.
Good job by Katie McNally. Get that ball out to Rookie of the Year, Dominic Monahan, but she ended up finding touch.
Wow, that was a 3-on-1. I can't believe they didn't touch that down.
Penalty against Guelph now. Coming in from the side of that ruck.
Even the second last player on that sin, if it a little dummy and cut it hard back in, could have been a try.
Murphy Burke finds some room for Pronghorns.
Well, hats off to Lethbridge on their tough defense, not letting Guelph over.
That was a nice play by Guelph to deliver the ball back to their scrum half into the open field.
No, Guelph's had two chances like that, plus a kick at goal, and they've come away empty. Scoreless here. Almost halfway through the first half.
Quick lineup maybe coming here.
Yep.
It is indeed.
Good.
Katie McNally with a good run.
Roll off. Good.
Crash ball for Guelph. And more phases coming.
Delay.
Penalty there against Guelph.
She didn't release that ball soon enough.
And Lethbridge will settle things down.
Yeah, we saw that Lethbridge leaving their feet there. I thought that may have been a penalty in Guelph's favor early on, but referee saw the not releasing call earlier.
And a good kick by Lethbridge.
This game will decide the bronze medal. 21 minutes to play in the first half.
And just like yesterday, we've got the four conference champions now in the medal games, and they're going to be good games. We knew this would be tight.
Keep it backing up.
Good low drive. And Guelph will maintain possession.
Efforts being made, three is trapped. Scrum
so we're halfway through the first half, and as mentioned, it's still scoreless despite the chances Guelph has had.
Guelph had a missed penalty kick earlier, and both teams had chances inside their opponent's 22. No points converted. We haven't seen a game under 10 points yet.
Pause, engage.
This may be it.
Eight, blue.
Good drive by Lethbridge.
Good ball, Brittany Benn with some room. Gets it back from her center.
Space out wide here.
One bounce.
No, knocked on. And no advantage to Lethbridge. Boy, there was a chance there too.
Benn had some room. Good give and take with her 12, Jane Kirby.
I get the feeling it's just a matter of time though here. Guelph has had some overlaps.
Blue, I'm holding the channel because you're
I think it's just a matter of time before they bust one through for a try.
Look at their game against St. FX yesterday. They controlled possession in the first half, worked their way down the field, and were rewarded in the corner.
Six, roll off,
nice job by Hendricks.
That'll be a tough loss. Hendricks slow to get up.
Mm-hmm.
Scrum half for Lethbridge. No.
That's a mall. She went down to save that ball, and I think she may have got her bell rung.
Thank you, six. If you go to date like that, just get out quick and we got you.
She gets some love there from her number eight. And she's staying in the game.
I'm not surprised.
We've seen teams banged up. We've seen bandaged knees.
Touch, pause, engage.
Well, tough for both these teams to come back after close games yesterday. Very physical games yesterday.
Good ball from Hendricks. Nice fake switch.
Oh, good
Brittany
play.
Orr with a good play to her opposition.
And that's done a good job of finding touch.
And good pursuit from Shannon Court there not to allow that quick lineout to happen.
So Lethbridge now down in the Guelph end, basically on the 22-meter line here. Exciting back play there by Lethbridge, Sandy.
Very good back and forth action. We know that both teams can find lots of room in the open field. Break tackles.
And roll!
Yeah, scores. She was rolling forward.
Second warning.
Nice to be able to hear the calls of the referee.
It's not a scrum, yes.
See what the explanations are on the penalties.
Brittany Benn to clear. Benton listed in the program as a center. We saw her being rested in the first game.
That's right.
But she has come in, we saw her yesterday in that game against St. FX playing number 10. Very key position for her. I'm not sure how much opportunity she's had to play that over the course of the season. Very versatile young woman.
She and J.C. Murphy, both CIS All-Canadians this year.
Murphy has hands on the ball right now. Guelph driving.
And a good drive.
Still advantage red.
Ball out to Benn. Back inside to number 7, Patricia
inside
Harris.
Inside again.
Another phase coming, J.C. Murphy. Another strong run. A little bit of a high tackle there.
Advantage is
off
over.
They go again.
That's Harris again. Good inside step.
Guelph on the move here.
All but not releasing.
Yeah, that's a good call.
Two on you now, 7. Please release. You're isolated.
You can hear the referee. Posey.
Sorry, Ed.
Oh, you can hear him saying, you're isolated. You have to let go of that ball when you
two
go to the deck.
Seven.
Good quick hands by the Pronghorns on that down tackler.
But some nice support there by the Guelph forwards.
The kick's going to stay in play. Reneva.
Could be trouble. Heard footsteps.
Good hard tackle and a drop. She's a little slow to get up.
Well, nice little chip ahead, but that's going to go
into
touch.
That stays in. Touch judge Jerry Clayton holds the mark for us.
Wow, Gavelin came up hard, put a big hit on the Guelph player who heard footsteps there. Nice high kick.
Yeah, winger Reneva. We've seen many teams having trouble here finding that ball of clouds. Giving players a bit of a hard time seeing that ball in the air.
And then there's the odd funny bounce off the turf, too. Playing on artificial turf here at the Justin Chiu Stadium at Trent University.
Ball off the top to Brandy Van Ewen.
Accidental, no idea. We'll scrum it in. Red ball. Totally accidental.
Running behind her own players.
Here's the mark.
No lead blocking in this game.
That was totally accidental.
Accidental, so we'll scrum it down. And
I'm holding the channel.
Put into Guelph.
Crouch.
We've played 25 minutes in the first half, and it's still scoreless. Got a great game going here.
Good drive by Lethbridge. Well, they've taken this one on the head. Austin Ogrens will have a run.
And roll.
She's got Rose Harris on her back.
Back it up.
They'll go again here.
All stolen by Guelph. Number 9, Lahou.
Four.
But she's on the wrong side of town.
Van Guelph looking to get that ball.
Guelph driving over. It's in the hands of DeVries.
2-1.
Referee seen something.
Captain.
Calling the
captain.
Captain over from Lethbridge.
No, sorry, let's play here.
What's he seeing there, Sandy?
I'm not sure. Some play on the bottom. Number 6. That's the Dewey Thompson at the bottom.
Yeah, something he didn't like there.
This is your only warning. Talk to your forwards. Let's get back it up. Okay.
Thompson's indicated not rolling. Not rolling away from the tackler. Once you've brought the Guelph player to the ground, you've got to release her.
Well, let's go.
Give her a chance to get out of there.
Thank you, Ray.
Second penalty for that.
Yeah.
So that's why you had the talk with him.
Yeah, referee Andrew Hosey. We've seen all the referees very, very good on the second infraction, speaking to the captains. Oh.
Back.
No, went backwards.
Oh, went backwards. Fortunate call for Kendra Gavilan.
Good recovery there. Gavilan brings it out to outside the 22.
Kick through by Alex Hendricks.
That's found some space. Look.
Oh. Taken by Brittany Orr.
Nice job by Orr.
And she's got Shannon Court on the outside. Oh, good offload. Back to Orr.
Some nice support by Lethbridge.
And Orr gets back to her fullback position.
Kick ahead by Murphy Burke.
Taken by McNally for Guelph.
Here's the ruck.
Good tackle by Laura Murphy Burke from Lethbridge.
All these teams are well matched, as the scoreboard shows. With only 12 and a half minutes left, still no score. Tight, tight defensive game.
Really is. Miranda Smith had a good take there for Guelph. They were moving forward, so they'll take this scrum. Just outside their 22. Still no score. 12 minutes left to play. First half of this bronze medal game.
Well, keep in mind, until St. FX scored 18 against Guelph yesterday, they hadn't had more than a converted try against them in one game all year.
Good.
You know they can play defense.
Four.
You know, I wouldn't be surprised to see a 0-0 game here after 80 minutes, the way this early first half is being played.
Onside, board two.
Here we go, Guelph in control. Happy just to pick and go with the forwards.
11 and a half minutes to play.
No.
Scrum to Guelph.
The effort's made, red are in possession. Thanks, too.
This is the third game being played by both teams in 4 days.
And both teams, as you said, Sandy, coming off very tight games yesterday.
Crouch.
They gave everything trying to get to the gold medal game.
Very emotional losses.
And penalty against Lethbridge.
Trying to take that scrum down.
Oh, she tried to take a quick
That's live ball. Ball it to Brittany Ben. She's got the corner.
Oh.
Oh, Reneva moves it backwards, though. Maybe not.
No, I was looking for a knock-on off that top of the penalty, Sandy.
I thought I was going to see the same. And there was a little bit of indecision on Guelph's part there after that play. I think they thought that was going to happen too. Hosey obviously fine with that play.
Mm-hmm.
He told us the ball was live.
Maybe he played it as a little kick ahead.
Touch. Pause. Engage.
Hendricks to put in for Lethbridge.
Use or lose. It's gone.
Ogren's taking it from the number two channel.
Not
releasing that ball on the ground.
Guelph with a quick tap. There's some
Murphy
space.
To
base.
That's six. Stephanie DeVries. Marielle Lahoux. That's in front of Ben. Picked up smartly.
Good recovery.
That's number 11, Marella Reneva. FX.
Beaton takes it back into the forwards.
DeVries again doing a great job.
Look at that. Good job by Guelph here.
Playing as an extra back. Oh, through the hands of number one, Lisa Shellington. 21 tackled hard for Guelph. That's Sharon Rafferty.
Another penalty awarded to Guelph, but this time they'll settle it down and look to find touch.
Still 9 minutes left. Lots of time for Guelph to move the ball inside Pronghorn 22.
And nice kick. Lands on the 22-meter marker.
Yeah, Lethbridge moving backwards again.
Touch judge and ref having a little discussion there.
Well, it's been a tug of war so far in the first half. No one really gaining any permanent ground. Loose ball off the top.
There's two there. First one is five.
Well, earlier on we did see Guelph with a couple excellent opportunities to score. One I was thinking was a sure thing to be in, but got taken out about 5 meters from the try line. Then we thought it was a sure three on that penalty kick almost in front of the post. That was missed. So the score remains 0-0.
Yeah, Guelph has left some points on the field.
Nine hold.
Good second strike for Lethbridge.
No, nine, you're off. It's taken in.
Murphy Burke. Chiu's behind her 22. That's fine.
Oh.
Jerry.
Yeah, that's Rafferty. Takes the ball out of play. Good kick from Murphy Burke there.
Hosey's calling that back, I believe.
I'm here to make you look good. That was taken back in by blue, red ball.
Oh, taken back in behind the 22 and then kicked.
That's a new rule that we've seen just in the last few years. Being played at all levels of rugby.
Ball!
You can't pass the ball back inside your own 22 and then clear it.
Back it up, blue. Keep it up.
A little humor from referee Andrew Hosey. I'm here to make the touch judges look good. Brittany Benn with the ball.
There's a nice run.
Jane Kirby into contact. Ball in Ben's hands again. Long spin pass out to her winger. That's Dominique Monaghan.
Unreleased now. Eight, roll off.
Ogren's in the bottom of the pile for Lethbridge.
The referee wants her out of there.
JC Murphy in to help.
Guelph is getting close.
They're about 6-7 meters out.
Pick and go again. To the blind side.
Good help from Caitlin Beaton in the forwards.
And now they'll swing it.
Katie McNally in. Good help from the fullback position.
No, good defense by Whidden.
That was 12. Jane Kirby taking it in aggressively for Guelph. Good take from DeVries.
Good defense by Lethbridge.
Lethbridge is a young team, but they certainly don't look like it here.
Rock, no,
trying the other side. Okay, Sandy, here's a chance for another three.
And they do have the option of taking a scrum if they wish.
Mm-hmm. Or they could give it to Murphy on the burst and try to get a try.
Now when you've got the CIS most outstanding player, that's an option.
Nope, they've signaled that they're going for posts.
Brittany Benn.
First one on the hands in.
So less than 6 minutes left, and it's scoreless with Guelph attempting a shot at goal to go ahead 3-0. Certainly has been everything we expected, Sandy.
that Sporrell did the kicking earlier, but no, they're going to put the ball back in Brittany Benn's hands. She's been their kicker full year long. Oh, that looks right.
Wow.
She's opened that one up.
Missed again.
Basically two
kicks from in front of the post have been missed by Guelph, and the score remains 0-0. We're under 5 minutes left in the first half.
That's a big boost to Lethbridge. They dodged a couple of bullets now.
Now you wonder if they shouldn't have run it if they're having some kicking problems.
I'll be curious to see if they get that position again. Taken well by Reneva. Good hard run into the forwards. Yeah, not staying on her feet there, Lethbridge.
To the speed here.
J.C. Murphy will drive forward. Stephanie DeVries with good second phase ball.
Oh, and there's a knock on. Guelph really does a good job of taking the ball at pace, though. I think the majority of the play has been to Guelph, though, Sandy, even though they haven't put any points on the board.
Well, they dominated possession against St. FX yesterday. Came up just on the short end of the score. But they do a very, very nice job of recycling ball, pardon me, getting both forwards and backs involved.
Taken in. Lethbridge scrum here.
Brittany Orr delivers a kick.
And a nice one.
It's taken in by Blue.
Oh, yeah, taken back in, just like last time, Sandy, but taken back behind the 22 and then kicked, so the lineout will come back.
There's got to be some communication there between those backs, noticing, talking to their kicker to let them know that if they do that, the lineout's going to their opposition back where the kick was made.
So they can still kick, but they need to bounce that in before it goes out.
That's right, or they may choose to run it if that's the case. Like I said, that's been a new rule just in the last couple of years.
Nice tackle. Hickey on the tackle there. Or they could just do what I do, Sandy, and never ever kick it. Don't even think about kicking it. Can't go wrong going north-south, right?
That's right. Players down.
So it'll be referee's timeout here with under 3 minutes left. How about the gold medal game coming up, Sandy?
Well, this is what we've all been waiting for, 4 days' worth of rugby. And after this, we'll be down to one game. Concordia, your Quebec Conference champions, and St. Francis Xavier, your Atlantic East. So Eastern Canada dominating this year's rugby.
Big wins for both teams yesterday. Concordia knocking off the three-time defending champions, Lethbridge. And then, as you mentioned, with the last-second try, St. FX sent Guelph to the bronze game. And Guelph had scored with about 2.5 minutes left in that game. You'll recall it was 17-13. No, sorry.
You're right, 17-13.
17-13 when St. FX scored. And there was some discussion between the referee and the touch judge to see whether that ball had been touched down in goal or whether touch and goal had been involved. And it was decided it was a try. And that was it for Guelph.
Looks like a back injury. We dealt with. We haven't seen who that is.
I think it's Shillington.
Number one. He got caught. We always want those players to turn, present their back, get the ball to their own side. But when you present your back to a strong team like Lethbridge, maybe a shoulder delivered there.
Yeah, she really took a spill there.
And she's very slow to get off.
So we got 2 minutes or less, plus injury time, and Guelph is going to put in the scrum inside Lethbridge's 22. A scoreless game as the first half winds down.
New front row, let's listen to the engage, please. Yeah.
We've got Katie McCreary in for Guelph.
Touch.
In the front row.
Pause, engage.
Oh, good defense by Lethbridge.
Loose ball on Guelph's side. Good take by Miranda Smith.
That's a maul.
They've set up to go again.
Oh, Lethbridge is off their feet again.
No call.
Oh, but driving well is Lethbridge.
Six release.
Good aggressive play in the
walk
forwards.
Back, six, walk it back.
Fighting for every single possession.
Yeah, they're really mixing it up. It's going to ground.
And penalty due to the Pronghorns.
No hands.
Hands in the rock.
Now, what about the job Bill Byrick, Brian Greer have done on these championships at Trent University in Peterborough here, Sandy?
No surprise. Two highly organized individuals. They've given us an excellent tournament. We talked about the work of Brian Greer earlier, trying to get the best young rugby players to a small university.
Well, Trent's got the built-in advantage of knowing they'll be in the championships again next year.
14, Kendra Gavlin, fields for Lethbridge. To Tiffany Woody, number 12.
Nice support. Rock.
Two good hard runs in their own end. Now time is off. He's gonna have words.
I think he's reaching in for the pocket there. Remember, he already had a little discussion earlier. So there's the yellow card.
Yellow card to number 12, Tiffany Woodin. Again, not rolling away from the tackle. That's he had addressed his the Lethbridge captain earlier.
We're playing.
And a player down for Guelph being tended to. That's Patricia Harris. Upper body injury. Stephanie DeVries on a good hard take for Guelph.
Nice run.
Ball stripped.
Not on by Red.
Good job by Kendra Gavlin to strip that ball. And time's off again. Some distress being experienced by Guelph flanker.
Everything good? Everything
good. Yep. It's like a shoulder. And who's that?
Patricia Harris off for Guelph. That's a key position to lose here in this bronze medal game.
Wow, this has been a real forwards game. Really mixing it up, as you mentioned. Time's back in. We've got to be down to final minute here in a scoreless game.
We've got number 18, Lindsay Peebles, into the game.
Touch.
Moving to the blind Boss side flank.
No. The hold is coming after the hit. 1, 2, 3. Sort them out, two. Okay. Hold the drive.
We've seen Peebles. She's had some play time earlier in this tournament, so not coming in completely green.
Use or lose.
Good quick wheel by Guelph.
Taken in.
Murphy Burke, not a lot of room to get that ball away.
Let's see if Guelph can counter
off
this.
Number 21, Rafferty.
Oh, nice tackle.
Taken well out of bounds by Kendra Gavlin.
Referee signals half.
Well, an outstanding half of rugby, Ed.
Wow, tight, hard hitting, and still scoreless.
Guelph's got to feel good about the half that they've played. They left two penalty kicks out there, but... multiple chances to score in that half. Well, that's good for us. We'll enjoy this halftime break, and we'll be back with you to the start of the second half. we're back with you from Trent's Justin Chiu Stadium for the start of the second half of the bronze medal game in the 2010 CIS Women's Rugby Championships. Sandy Kane, Ed Holton with you.
What a physical first half, and no score.
Great opening half of rugby between these two division champions.
Really mixing it up.
Ruck!
It's Dewey Thompson with a good take right off the opening kickoff.
It's been touched.
Box kick through by Alex Hendricks. Ogren's in pursuit.
Nice tackle.
Good smothering Pronghorns defense. Got to watch those sidelines.
Got her into touch. Another player down.
21 Rafferty. Not a player down, 21 Rafferty taking the ball out of bounds.
Four.
Short line out now by Lethbridge. All good hands by Ogren's. That's number four, Stacey Hake. And second phase to Dewey Thompson. Not going anywhere though in these phases. Of got to make the gain line. Chip through by number 10, Murphy Burke. Oren in pursuit.
Ruck!
Good stand-up defense by the Pronghorns. Ball to Stephanie DeVries.
There's a ruck two on site.
Been impressed with her play so far today. High kick, nobody there. Oh, not a bounce there.
No. Would have bounced. Would have been some space there.
Dominique Monaghan was in good position to field that. Well done for Guelph to find that open wing. Four in, another short line out. Thompson up. Ball out, Murphy Burke. Picked up off the turf nicely.
Oh, he's not calling a knock on there, is he? Ooh. Looks like she'd grabbed that.
Looks like number seven, Patricia Harris, back in the game. Crouch, touch, pause. After that injury.
Wow, good for her.
This is a medal game at the CIS Championships. Crunch. Last game of the season.
All winter to rest.
Touch.
And recover.
Pause. Engage. Use or lose.
Clean strike by Guelph. JC Murphy taken well. Good pace fullback Katie
Six
McNally. Second phase coming. Brittany Benn goes wide. Breaks a tackle.
Ruck! No hands!
Referee signals for Pronghorn hands to get off that ball. Good take, number 18, Lindsay Peebles for Guelph.
Lethbridge is stolen, though.
And good job to clear by Laura Murphy Burke. Now Guelph will get the ball back. Still inside the Lethbridge Pronghorns 22.
Not straight.
Not straight.
It's tough.
Tough call going against Guelph.
That hurts to get inside the other team's 22 and then give it back like that.
Scrum coming to Lethbridge inside their own 22.
Now we're playing 40-minute halves today in these championship games. We're 4 minutes in.
Still scoreless.
44 minutes of rugby and no score.
Down.
Oh, it's blocked. Marielle LeHoux and DeVries.
And there's our try. Wow. Well up by Guelph. Block kick into the end goal and it's touchdown. And it's a 5-0 game for Guelph.
Good work by DeVries.
Well called, Chris Asmus. Thank you very much.
Well, Guelph finally rewarded for all their hard work.
That was good pressure there. LeHoux did a great job to get after that ball. I think it was her that blocked it. And Stephanie DeVries takes it over. Julie Thompson with that try. We're getting another look at it right here. There's the block.
block kick, and Thompson just going right after it. Took a great line and covered that one up.
So 5 minutes in, we finally have our first score. 5 minutes into the second half, and Guelph has scored a try to go up 5-0. And the fans, the Guelph supporters, love it.
Brittany Benham, a more difficult kick now for two.
After missing two in front of the post, we'll see if Guelph can get this convert. Nope.
No, that's going right. 5 points nonetheless.
Well, we kind of discussed, we thought that Guelph certainly dominated the possession in the first half, so there's their reward.
Yeah, Shannon Court with a quick kickoff, fielded at the 22 by Dominic Monahan.
Long kick and well up on defense. See players inside.
Good move by DeVries, the try scorer. J.C. Murphy threw nicely. Caught from behind. And good quick ball. I think the Lethbridge back line was offside there.
Oh,
Brittany Ben finds some room. Good slashing run by Ben. Has a little kick. Support was slow to get to her. Pair of knock-ons. Guelph will keep possession.
Oh, I think Ben should have kept that in hand. Whenever a Guelph player takes off, you always see someone, both sides of them in support.
Very well organized. This is a senior squad compared to their opposition from Lethbridge. Roster filled with third and fourth year players. A lot of them.
Hats off to Lethbridge for competing with them.
This may be the last chance for a number of these Guelph Gryphons at the national championships.
Roll it!
They've been here 11 times now as a school. 42 games played, an impressive record.
Looks like there's going to be a captain's warning with this one as well.
No. Third time now on number 8. No waving is going to save that, okay? That's the third one on that specific player.
Yellow card coming to number 8, Austin Ogrens.
Yeah, he said third time. Third time he's told her.
Very consistent play from referee Andrew Hosey. He's from New Brunswick. Guelph charging again. Inside the 22. Lethbridge being tested here in the second half.
Nice line out and drive by Guelph.
Driving ball held up well against. Some sloppy play there from both sides.
Mm-hmm. Knocked on by Guelph. I wondered if Lethbridge was taking that down, but the referee said they Guelph did it themselves.
Crouch! Touch!
So remain.
Clear for Lethbridge. Oh, good push in the scrum.
Doing on these scrums to compensate.
That other player has the same issue. Okay, you've got to. I don't mind people leaving accidentally. Roll back, not forward. You're taking away the materiality of all the contest.
Our referee's got time out here, it seems. It's our time back in. Possession to Lethbridge.
Touch, pause, engage.
Murphy Burke set. Another big push by the Gryphons. I said they've...
16 red.
You want to wheel in defense, but penalty if it's done too quickly or incorrectly.
Nope.
That'll stay as Lethbridge possession on the penalty. Lethbridge right at their own 22. Jimmy Thompson up well for Lethbridge. Good driving maul by Lethbridge.
Excellent.
No, that's blue.
Great body position on that maul. Nice and low. Oh, a hesitation by Hendricks.
Oh, that's dangerous.
Oh, right in the hands of Brittany Benn.
That's not who you want to kick it to.
CIS All-Canadian. Lahou looking for the ball, though.
No hands, there's the rook!
Being spoiled by the Pronghorns.
Guelph's
great low ruck by Guelph. Lahou to deliver. Out to number 12, Jane Kirby.
And a good run.
She's spinning through. Inside 5 meters now.
Ruck!
Hold it!
Big tough battle here. Right near the Pronghorn goal line. Help from Guelph. Good take. That's DeVries on the side. She's not happy with just her one try. She's looking for more. Ball out to Ben.
Oh, what a tackle.
Good dump tackle.
Unreleased 10.
That was number 13, Shannon Court.
No, you'd lost. I got you.
Spilled forward in the tackle. A great tackle it was.
Player down on that.
Wow, what a tough defense by Lethbridge.
Brittany Benn, a key player for Guelph, feeling the effects of that dump tackle. She's up.
Getting a warm round of applause from her fans.
Big part of the Guelph offense, Brittany Benn. We've mentioned CIS All-Canadian. Time is out. We've got the trainer coming out to look at her. 28 minutes on the clock and counting. Guelph with a narrow 5-0 lead. Yeah, a round of applause for her. She's back up. At the same time, we've got a Lethbridge player down in the end goal.
That player is off the field. We're going to continue, okay?
Referee says that player is off the field. They're going to continue play.
16.
Trample the injured, Ed.
She's off the field. Has she been replaced? Does that mean?
No, she's just being helped off now. Well, that's number 7, Patricia Harris again. She's had a tough go today.
Mm-hmm. Oh, look at that push by
Big
Guelph.
Drive, pressure. Number 6, Dewey Thompson, does a good job to get it free from that scrum.
Dead ball.
Well, some good hands by Lethbridge inside their own 22, and they're able to clear that, relieve some of the pressure. This ball off the top.
See, we've got number 21 in for Lethbridge. We'll try and get you her name. Haddon.
Keep it shut.
What a steal by Lethbridge.
Play the advantage.
Advantage being played. And it'll
ladies,
be
I am in white. Pay attention to that.
Knocked on by Lethbridge, so we will have a scrum with Guelph put in.
On him.
5-0 Guelph.
I'm on the channel.
One unconverted try is the only scoring so far in this game.
Crouch!
It wasn't an exciting try, a block kick.
That's Marley Haddon for Lethbridge.
The burst here.
Good take by Katie McNally at fullback.
McNally comes in at full pace.
Shirt tackle made by Lethbridge. Lahou delivers. Forwards going blindside. Smith to Dominique Monahan.
Boy, Guelph is making Lethbridge tackle, that's for sure.
Nice delivery there. Ben mishandles.
Knocked on.
Ben maybe still a little rattled after that injury.
Impressed with the Lethbridge tackling, Sandy.
For a young team, they've looked great here, defending their own end. Guelph's had possession. Last 10 minutes or so, they've been anchored inside this Pronghorn 22.
Into touch, so Lethbridge gets a line out.
It's a tough play for a winger not to want to get their hands on it. Had she let it go, it would have bounced maybe clear. It would have been Guelph line out. One nice ball from Hendricks. Murphy Burke. All blocked by Ben.
Here's
21 Marley Haddon.
Hands in the ruck there.
No, player down for Lethbridge.
12 and captain. Okay. And this is your warning. It applies to the whole team. We've had one too many. When I call ruck, that means a ruck is formed. No hands must go in. You were not the tackler. No hands. Tell everyone. Okay. Thank you.
Referee Hosey giving instruction to the Guelph captains, but hands in the ruck. When he calls ruck, he wants to see hands removed.
And as we've seen this tournament, that warning means don't do it again. Yellow card could be coming.
He's been a man of his word.
A little sloppy play there.
Dominique Monaghan down now for Guelph. So certainly a testament to the hard-hitting nature of this game. Number of injuries.
Mm-hmm. We've probably seen more players down in this game than any other. So time's out, and we have 23 minutes left in this game and a 5-0 lead to Guelph.
Now we'll be looking for her replacement.
Jerry, you deal.
Jerry Clayton offering that sub.
Crouch. Touch. Pause. Engage.
That's Katie Arbor in number 23 for Guelph, for the injured OUA rookie of the year. Scrum is wheeled. Ball to Guelph. Lethbridge really needing to sustain something. We've seen good hard play from their forwards, but it's been a while since we've seen the backs really moving those that ball crisply.
Mm-hmm.
Brittany Orr, a little stale back there at the fullback position.
Yeah, time for some offense for Lethbridge.
Orr's a real weapon back there, but she just hasn't been involved in play.
Nice pickup.
JC Murphy, big hard run. Does a good job to get back to her feet.
You're tackled.
No, she didn't release that. Referee needs to see a bit of an attempt just to get that ball out of your hands while you're getting back to your feet. That didn't happen. Shannon Court. Was a great run.
She is quick on that number 8 pickup, Sandy.
And a big, strong girl. You wouldn't expect speed like that from her, but she is ferocious in open field. Very difficult to take down.
Knocked forward by Lethbridge line.
Good ball to Stephanie DeVries. Tackle up a little high. LeHoux fakes the pass.
Going the other way.
Out to Murphy on the wing. Delivered nicely. Smart little offload inside.
Nice support.
Good phases for Guelph, and they've eaten up some field.
Using the field well, too.
21 minutes left. Still a 5-0 game to Guelph. Tap off the top to Lethbridge. Stolen well. Good run. That's Caitlin Beaton, I believe, for Guelph.
tackling by Lethbridge.
Back it up there, three.
Number two, Brandy.
Then knocked on by Guelph.
Well, who with a bit of a bobble there. Sub coming. Sinbin players returned. That's Ogren's back in the game. They've got their full. And that's number 17, Miranda Smith, leaving the game. Good play from her. Gets hugs from her coaching staff.
Blue ball, it is inside. Blue.
The referee say it started inside the 22, which means they can kick straight into touch. Kick up the center, and here they come on the counterattack.
Tyrrell!
Phillips into the game for Guelph at lock.
Space on
wearing
the
number, wearing number 25.
Rock.
Back inside. Good take by Caitlin Beaton. Ball out to Ben. Some room on the outside. That's the overlap. Got to get some help there from Rafferty.
And there's the rock. No hands.
Rafferty over on this side. Lahou in to get ball. Who digs for that ball? Number three, Catherine Wilson.
Rock.
Good crush.
No feet.
And ball out again. Ball to DeVries. She's been a tough, tough player at the flank position today. Number 12, good move back inside. Jane Kirby.
Rock.
LeHou. And out. That's 18 Peebles for Guelph.
Good Guelph work here by Guelph.
Guelph moving all over the field. Exhausting for Lethbridge on defense. Ball again to Ben.
Some numbers out here for Guelph.
12.
Could be.
They've got numbers over.
And
that's a close call. That was Rafferty very close. He may have a discussion with his touch judge here.
Mm-hmm. He's called time, and he's going to talk to his touch judge.
That's Chris Osmus on this near sideline.
Thank you very much.
And try given. Chris Osmus in good position to see that. A quick chat between the two officials. And Guelph has a 10-0 lead.
Wow, how many phases was that for Guelph, though? That was excellent rugby.
That was beautiful play, utilizing the field. Crash ball from the forwards, swung out smartly to the backs. Very nice ball movement.
Wow, like you said, excellent use of the field. They were way over on the far side, scored it in the opposite corner. So really spread Lethbridge out. Wow, Lethbridge has done a great job in defense, but it's only so many phases you can defend against.
Brittany Benn will get her composure here. She's got a minute to get this kickoff. She'd use much of it.
So 16 minutes left in the game. And Guelph has two tries. 10-0 for Guelph at this point with the convert coming.
Yeah, it's going to be hooked wide.
18 minutes left, tell everyone. 10-0 Shannon?
Oh, you heard the referee, 18 minutes.
So it looks like, about, 15, looks like about 2.5 minutes in addition to what we see on the scoreboard.
Lots of time, though, Sandy.
Very much so. Two scores is not insurmountable at all for this three-time national championship team.
If they can get a converted try, then they'll just need a penalty goal. And here's a good opportunity for them right off the restart.
Knocked by Peebles on the restart. We saw that yesterday at against St. FX, a drop off the restart, and that led to the winning try by St. FX.
Straight through, the ball.
So let's see if the same holds true and we get the Pronghorns coming down for a score.
Still on you to straighten up. Red Hooker, squeeze the girls in, please. Crouch, touch, pause, engage. 9.
Lethbridge ball, Murphy Burke out to Spurrell.
Nice play. Little break there.
Scooped up by number 11, Laura Brown.
Rook, no hands.
Ball playable there. Number 16. Pardon me, number 6, Dewey Thompson. Ball from Hendricks. Good spin pass.
Oh, whoa. That's a high tackle.
Big high tackle on number 2, Brandy Van Ewen.
No, not on a foul play like that.
No.
I know. First one in the game. Everyone keeps him down, all right?
I would take the 3 here, Sandy, and get within 1 converted try. And she's down, too.
That was a dangerous tackle.
No, not with a match.
No yellow card, referee. Andrew Hosey saying that that was the first offense.
And I think he knows that was unintentional.
A very impressive front row for the Lethbridge Pronghorns. We've got
Lethbridge coming back, Sandy, with some nice rugby of their own.
Oh, they know their backs are against the wall now. They've got to put points on the board here with just about 15 minutes left, 14 and a half minutes.
13 on the clock, and we heard Hosey say that a couple minutes injury time. She's okay.
Yeah, she's got her composure now.
Hands on me, not ahead of number 2.
Her replacement came in yesterday for Jillian Kudowitz, who started off the tournament playing hook, but she was injured. Lethbridge running out of hookers, so she sucks it up.
Here, an important kick. There it is. Getting the ball back here in a second. Look at the great job the ball.
Great arm. It's number 21, Marley Haddon. Little box kick there from Hendricks. The two number 8s colliding there. Good low ruck from Guelph. Lahou. Up from Stephanie DeVries. She's been there all game long. Good ball from Guelph. We've seen this from them before.
Oh, there's a bounce into Lethbridge hands.
Ruck, no hands. 18 red.
Guelph playing defense. Kick through from Hendricks. Charged by number 15, Katie McNally.
Well up.
Ruck.
Guelph back in possession near midfield. Oh, not a good pass. DeVries making Ruck. Something out of nothing.
Back it up, Blue.
Ben with a nice left-footed kick.
Nice take.
Charge taken well by number 11, Laura Brown.
Ruck. 10.
Kicking back and forth here all of a sudden. Well up by
Ruck.
Laura.
No hands. There's the ruck. No hands.
12 minutes to play. Still plenty of time for Lethbridge. Ball out to Guelph. Brittany Benn again. Nice little offload to her center.
Oh, nice stop by Lethbridge.
No hands, red!
Possession not clear here. Comes out the Lethbridge side.
Oh, nice move.
13 Shannon Court. Takes it inside the Guelph 22.
Still in play.
Ball out the Guelph side. Ruck form now. Oh, knocked forward. Knocked forward. Referee indicates. Playing advantage. Wadeen, good step back inside.
She's got some room.
She's got some room now, 5 meters. Forwards are there.
This could be it for Lethbridge.
I think advantage has been made. 10, Laura Murphy-Burke keeps herself.
And she is.
She's.
Oh.
No, held up.
Time's off. Well, hang on. He's going to talk to the touch judge.
Time's
again.
Off. He's going to have a word.
That is a try.
Try given.
I thought she was in. Wow, that makes a score 10-8 now for Guelph with the convert coming. Oh, Lethbridge has really turned it on, Sandy.
What a great last 10 minutes of play from them.
Let's see if they can make this convert to tie the game.
That's certainly a makeable convert. Not easy. Murphy Burke's got to finish her own work, and she's a little shaken up from that tackle on the goal line.
That was a nice burst up the center there by her. So we've got 8.5 minutes plus injury time and a chance for Murphy Burke to tie the game.
If we see a tie score, Ed, should tell the people watching that we will be playing sudden death overtime, 10 minutes each way if needed.
Mm-hmm. Big kick.
It's up, a little short, off the post.
Oh, man.
How
tough luck.
Very, very close.
Boy, that was close.
Very nicely struck by Burke. Just that close to tying that score. 10-8 now.
10-8 and a penalty kick can win it.
Pronghorns back in possession. Kick through by Brittany Orr. Very nicely kicked. McNally trying hard to keep that ball in bounds. And she... No.
Now, even if she kept it in, she can't go out of bounds and come back in.
Blue ball.
Jerry Clayton very good on the mark on that far sideline.
10, more than 10.
Well, we expected a tight game, Ed, and that's exactly what we've got. 2-point differential. About 9 minutes to play.
Oh, scoreless for the longest time, and now after all this time,
sorry, Jerry, Michael,
approaching 75 sorry. Minutes of rugby, it's only 10-8.
Now, we've seen that the Pronghorns are very capable of moving the ball back down into Guelph's ends. One penalty is all it takes now. You've said it. Pronghorn penalty kick, and they can take the lead back. Ball it to Brittany Bent for Guelph. Back inside to her flanker, Stephanie DeVries.
Been so impressed with the tackling today by the Lethbridge side.
J.C. Murphy with room down the outside.
Ruck!
Does a good job to stay in bounds. Ball swung wide.
Ruck, no hands!
Well taken by the Guelph forwards. And ball recycled. Brittany Benn looking for a gap. Oh, she's got it. And nicely offloaded number 12, Jane Kirby. She kicks through between the winger and the fullback. Oh, and looking for pressure.
Oh, now she was looking outside her. I thought she was looking to throw the big spin pass to the winger. Instead, she kicked it forward.
Sweet little play there. Brittany Orr did a good job to clear that end. Pressure coming from the Guelph centers.
Time's off.
What do you think about that decision to kick, San?
Oh, I thought that was a good one. She saw something there, and she put
blue,
the fullback and the winger on their heels.
She signaled to her winger that she was going to put the ball out there.
It was a one-on-two, so I think that was a pretty good decision. Dewey Thompson out of the game. Fresh legs with about 7 minutes left. Number 24, Blaze, in the game.
Blaze, I believe.
Oh, nice line out.
Good driving ball by Guelph.
Now inside the 22 of Lethbridge. Oh, spilled forward in the tackle.
Kristen Blay in the game for Lethbridge. At the flank, replacing.
Thompson's out.
Let's go, Horns! Push harder!
That's right, Ed. Just thank you. Dewey Thompson out of the game. It's 6 minutes, touch. Give or take.
Touch.
This one, ball coming
engage.
To Lethbridge. Good hard scrum. Body's flying.
What a great finish this is going to be. Four and a half on the clock. A little bit of injury time.
Fighting for a bronze medal at the CIS Championships.
Crouch. Touch. Pause. Engage.
Another put into Lethbridge. Ball squeaks out. Taken nicely by her flanker. Kick through, well taken by Katie McNally.
Nice job by McNally.
Nice spinning sidestep. Ball to Marielle Lahou. JC Murphy with a big hard run.
She's had a great game.
Good crash ball. Lucky that DeVries was able to handle that handoff.
Mm-hmm.
Brittany Benn, they've got some numbers outside. Back inside Jane Kirby.
Three more out here.
Brittany Benn with the ball again. Katie McNally. Oh, does a nice cut back up the middle.
Rook.
Ball out to number three, Catherine Wilson. Ball out to Lahou. Murphy.
Oh, nice tackle. We'll go again. Oh.
That's Jillian Ankutowicz back into the game.
He's knocked on by Guelph.
She's tough wearing luck. Number 19. She was a starting hooker earlier on in this tournament. In today's replacement.
Well, this Guelph team is well-drilled, well-coached, Sandy.
Two excellent programs, two excellent teams, and just 2 points separating them. Alex Hendricks. Putting in wheel from Guelph. Ogrens takes that ball. Hendricks ripped down as she tries to deliver that ball. And he's got Guelph coming in offside.
Mm-hmm.
That'll give Lethbridge some breathing room.
Such a physical game. Two teams have really mixed it up.
And this is the third game for them in 4 days. They're working solely on guts now and adrenaline. They'll have a bounce up. Taken nicely by Marilla Reneva. Good hard run back into the middle. She's met by the Lethbridge pack. Scrum coming to Guelph.
So 2 minutes or less on the clock, time being kept by the referee, plus injury time. We're winding down.
He indicated earlier that we may have an additional two and a half minutes.
So we'll call it about 4 minutes overall, maybe. We'll listen for the referee, see what he says.
Ball in for Guelph. Katie McNally had to slow down for that one, but she's got possession. That's Brittany Benn with it. Shannon Court does a good job on defense to tie the ball up. Lou out quickly. DeVries crashing. Well, forwards there nicely. That's number two, Brandy Van Nguyen. In well at the 22. Another scrum coming to Guelph. That ball not able to be presented. Brittany Benn doubled over.
Well, this is what Guelph wants for the last few minutes. Keep it down in the Lethbridge end and keep it in the forwards.
We've lost communication with the referee. That's fine. We'll let the players decide this. JC Murphy, good strong take by Guelph.
24's got to get out of there.
She's working hard at it.
She's pretty trapped.
Ball from the scrum half. Out to Jane Kirby. Nice switch to the fullback, Katie McNally. That was a smart play by Lahou. We were not set behind her. Takes it into contact. Forwards will pick up the slack. Good driving maul. Katie McCreary. Hands on this ball. Keeps it in Guelph's possession. Ball passed behind Ben, but she does a good job scooping it up. Good ruck by Guelph in possession. JC Murphy looking for a gap on the edge.
A few more yards.
Oh, stripped by LeHou. DeVries back to the middle of the field.
Nice recovery.
Ball back out. Kirby. Good straight arm. She gets a corner.
Oh, it's that interception.
Well done by Lethbridge.
This could be the break they need to turn it.
They've got to get this ball downfield. Hendricks having a hard time finding that ball. Ah, penalty coming to Lethbridge. Yellow card. Scrum half LeHou. That's a difficult one. She was at the bottom of that pile there. We said earlier, Ed, the game can't end on a penalty.
Mm-hmm.
And if he's got a little bit of time left, I think they're just checking to see how much time exactly is there. Number four injured for Lethbridge. That's Stacey Hake. She's coming over to the sideline to get attended to.
Well, it looks like she is going to kick for touch, so she must know that there's another play coming.
Oh, no, tapped to court.
Oh!
Almost picked off by Jane Kirby, but knocked on. Lethbridge, I think, has got to keep this ball in play now.
Mm-hmm.
Time running out for them. Bronze medal in Guelph sights.
Maybe a minute left. It's 10-8 for Guelph. Lethbridge just needs to get in the other end and close enough for a penalty kick or a try to win.
Ball back to Laura Murphy-Burke.
She's not going to...
She gets that kick away, coming right to Reneva. She bobbles it backwards. Good tackle by Brittany Orr. That's Laura Brown picking up the slack.
Lethbridge needs this ball.
Brown retreating back to fullback as Brittany Orr returns.
They need to create a turnover.
Ball back in Griffin hands. Guelph will look to just get this ball out of bounds. Good little pop at Jane Kirby.
Nice run.
Oh, miscue by Caitlin Beaton.
It's not the end of the game.
No, he says we'll have at least one more go at it.
This has got to be the last go, Sandy. Last chance for Lethbridge.
This young Lethbridge team has shown us a real heart here, real battle against a very senior Guelph Gryphon side. Ball out, possession coming to Lethbridge here, it looks like. Good take off the ruck, good low drive. Penalty to Lethbridge. Now they're going to have to tap and go.
Yep.
Good job by Hendricks. Good attack. They got room outside. Oh, unfortunate pass. Scooped up.
Ooh.
Oh, referee's played advantage.
He's got an offside.
Not 10 on the penalty tap. Not 10. That's an interesting call. I didn't think that... it really interfered. Any of those players, not 10, really didn't get at the ball. But that's his call, not ours. Yeah, we're at midfield now. Lethbridge has got to keep this ball in play. Tap and swung nicely. Murphy Burke. Oh, good hard hit by Austin Ogrens. Yeah, good possession. Number three, Nikki Van Eck. For Lethbridge. Lots of bodies on the ground.
Knocked on by Guelph.
And that'll do it.
There's the game.
We have our bronze medalists, the Guelph Gryphons.
Wow, full marks to Lethbridge, though. They really battled hard. What a physical game. The three-time CIS champions have to settle for fourth this year, but they really gave Guelph a good game.
They did. An excellent effort by both teams. Close as we expected, 10-8. And great job by a young Lethbridge Pronghorns team.
So only one game left to go, and that's the gold medal game coming up here, St. FX against Concordia.
That's the one that everyone's been waiting for. We'll decide a national champion here.
Player of the game awards go to number 6 of Guelph, Stephanie DeVries, and number 13 of Lethbridge, Shannon Quartz.
Well, great call there by the decision makers, player of the game. Shannon Court for Lethbridge, number 13. And a great choice in Stephanie DeVries, number 6, the flanker for Guelph.
Oh, congratulations to both teams on an excellent game.
And excellent, very entertaining. So that's it for the bronze medal. Last two medals left to go. We'll be back to Trent's Justin Chiu Stadium. We'll be back with you for the start of the gold medal game from the 2010 CIS Women's Rugby Championships.